I will make your server absolutely strong. First, position your Wick bot properly. Place it above members and below staff role. Now run this command. Every bot has that, so no surprises. You can find all the Wick commands here. This will be new to you. Use this to set up Wickbot. Ignore this message. Basically, it just adds quarantine role, which is its mute role. Now add three channels, logs, mod logs, and appeals. You'll know about that later. Make sure only staff can view these channels. Now we are at the Wicks dashboard. Don't be intimidated. I will teach you what's important here. Let's set up logs. Ignore the first two for now and click Customize. I'm telling you this because you can set up logs for separate things like, let's do appeals first. Now what is appeals? Let's say if someone gets punished by Wickbot, they can make an appeal to prove their innocence. Maybe hearing their side of the story could make you to have a change of heart. This is why I asked you to create three channels at the start. I will show you how it looks in my main server. Under the appeal, you can accept or deny to deny and blacklist them so they won't appeal again. Let's do automod logs. This is when bot punishes a user, it gets registered there. Add the mod logs channel here. Easy? This is why I told you to create this channel at the start of this video. Now we will focus on miscellaneous logs, which is our regular logs. Things like message deleted and joining updates and other things will be recorded here. In mod logs, you can simply add your mod logs channel. Both automod and mod logs are the same. Now that the logs are over, let's head over to appeals. I will give you a super short tutorial here. Just enable appeal, that's it. Now let's set up automod. It works on heat system. First, enable automod status and automod timeouts and click save. That's it. Now go to filters. Here, we will from bottom to top. First is link blacklist, enable it. Keeping the heat 100% means if someone sends the link, they will be timed out or punished right away, like no chances will be given. Here you can add any link that you don't want people to send or the links that someone's repetitively spamming. Now let's do word blacklist. Enable only the top toggle. Not need to enable second, third, and fourth toggles. Add the words to the blacklist for the bot to block it. Now it's fine for some servers that allow swear words, but this could come in handy for family-friendly server like mine. If you don't know what wildcard words are, well, let's say you added the word berry, and if someone says strawberry, it will still be blocked because it has berry in that word. Strict words section don't offer you that feature, but you need to add words carefully in the wildcard words section. Now NSFW links, you need to enable it just in case some maniac joins your server one day and starts spamming 18 plus adult NSFW links. Here you can set the punishment as ban, but I should warn you that even bots can mistake a normal link for NSFW, so that's up to you. Now I will skip to invite links since malicious links was the same as NSFW link. Well, an invite link, I set the punishment to ban. I don't want people to spam their server links in my server and self-promote. You can do what you like. In anti-spam section, they give you various options like emoji spam, similar messages, Zalgo, GIF, and whatnot. You can enable whatever you want. Every server is different and faces different problems, so enable it accordingly. If someone's mentioning you too many times, you can enable mention. It's for pings. You can set the punishment here. So yeah, hope you get it. Here you can punish someone from sending media stuff, stickers, or files. Now let's see how to make our friends safe from this bot. Go to whitelist section. Here you will find various sections. You can keep your friends safe from certain things. We will get to that. But first in members section, you just need to copy your friend's user ID and paste it here. It's super cool. If you don't have copy user ID option, go to developer's mode and turn it on. Now there we can keep single member safe. What if you want to keep an entire role safe? Add any role here, but I highly recommend you to add staff role. Here you can keep a certain channel or channel safe, which means bot won't get triggered over spam in that channel. You can add staff channel or ticket channel, I guess. Anything you like. Now category is quite the same as channel. I am sure you got the gist of how it works, so I won't show this. We will skip to invite part now. Invite links basically means which member and role can send invite links in your server. You can decide and add it. I am sure you know how to do it, but make sure to add staff role. So yeah, I am sure. I don't have to show this in detail since you have seen how it works in spam section. You just need to keep repeating it all over. The same with other sections too, like mention and everyone. Now let's go to anti-nuke. Do you know what nuking a server means? It means to just delete everything that's there inside the server, like channels, roles, and banning all the members, and sometimes even deleting your entire server. Hackers can do this by bots. So just enable anti-nuke and that's it. Now go to the filters. It also has separate sections like automod does. In kicks and bans, you can set a limit on the number of members a staff can ban or kick, so that way they don't go berserk and start banning everyone. Everything here has to do with setting limit, like your staff can't do something more than that. Don't worry, even if the staff crosses the limit, the bot won't punish them. It just warns them. Like role creation, deletion, channel creations, and channel deletion are all the same. In every deletion section, set the heat to 100%, so even if a rogue staff or hacker manages to delete one role or channel, the bot will be triggered and stops the staff. Now joingate? Enable it. This is important. Here, you can control on who can join your server. Enable bot additions. Remember I said? That hackers can add bots to your server and delete everything. If you enable bot additions and unverified bot additions, Wick will ban that bot if it tries to join. Ignore no avatar and suspicious account. You can enable advertising name, but make sure to set the punishment accordingly. Now this one is the coolest, something that Discord should have. You can set the account age here. In my server, I have set 7 days. If a new account joins my server, they get banned. You can set whatever days you want. So yeah, now username is similar to word blacklist that we did for automod. Add all the bad words here. So if a member of that name joins, they get punished. Now it can affect new members who join the server and also the ones who are already existing. They will be punished if they have blacklisted names. Now that the join gate is over, we will focus on permits. Let's say it's similar to whitelist, but it's like an upgraded version where you can add staff members. Here, if you have a second founder or multiple founders, just add them here. They will be immune to everything. Now I am adding my own account's user ID because I don't have anyone else to test this thing on. Here it's the same, you have to add your admin. I will skip this part. Do you see the action button? Click that, here you can add your additional staff. First name it staff in general section and add staff role. Here you can give them immunity. Now remember, they didn't ask you this in founder and admin? That's because they get full immunity. Here, you can give them automod immunity and that's it. I guess that's it about Wickbot tutorial.